tried to pay for it all. Bring some gap on my plate. Garlic noodles and steak.
It's just like the millennials, they don't really have no type of structure of just having respect for certain things. Like, of course, certain people would be like, yeah, you know, blah, 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 this guy, you know, him losing his life, and then for his wife, well, it's not really his wife, they was engaged, but they was never married. But, you know what I'm saying?
His partner, his love.
It's a soulmate, and you see how the way that she's taking the whole thing, like, for you to come in and intercept and say some shit like that, like, yo, like, that was very disgusting. Like, this is not somebody who you just would just say some, like, on some real disrespectful shit to. Like, I'm pretty sure if, like, one of the city girls would have lost their boyfriend or some shit, then it's like, nah, niggas really wouldn't care. But some people would, some people wouldn't. But it's just like, you seeing how the way this man was, and for you to come out and say this on Instagram Live, and don't think people's not gonna have an opinion, right, was just crazy. But it's also more crazy than how, like, people think that shit is cool just to say whatever. Oh, well, you know, he dead. He not even here to defend himself. Right. That's just the fucked up part about it.
I say it like this, you know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, like, yo, someone loses someone, that's hard, bro, for anybody. I mean, you know what I'm saying? Good, bad, whatever. When you lose someone, bro, that is a hard thing to do. And I say that come from experience. I mean, my brother, I had a twin brother pass away when he was 5 years old, you know what I'm saying? So I understand when you lose someone close to you and how it feels. And that grieving period is not a week or 10 days or 2 months or a year, bro. The grieving period is however long it takes that individual, you know what I'm saying? And so for you to disrespect that by going out and saying, well, I'm gonna think with my dick, and my dick says I want Lauren London or whatever. You know what I'm saying? And then on social media, on that type of platform, where you got millions of people watching, mm-hmm. I mean, it truly just shows, you know what I'm saying, what your morals and your values are all about. You know what I'm saying? So mm-hmm. It sucks. It sucks that, you know, these are the type of people that are leading the music industry right now, that are leading that have such an influence, you know, on what we're doing in today's society, and they take that shit for granted. And by doing stuff like this, I mean, I'm really just proud of the people who have sat down and said, and stood up, not even sat down, but stood up and said, this is not where we should be at, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying? And this is not acceptable. And I need y'all to understand that, you know what I'm saying? Especially because the younger folks growing up, they need to know, everyone needs to be chin-checked.
In fact.
Everyone got to be chin-checked at some point, you know what I'm saying? So it's just like, I appreciate that, but I really, it is disgusting that, you know, that cut out, it's ignorant, and it's sad, and I hope that, you know what I'm saying, I hope that people are paying attention, bro.
I hope so, because you just can't come out and say shit like that. And then for people who thought that it was corny for T.I. or the rest of the rappers to come out and say what they said, like, I was like, oh man, you know, he should have called him, whatever. Hell, sometimes you gotta reach somebody how the way they reach you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's like, if for anybody, it's like somebody saying something about my man, you know what I'm saying? Like, yo, oh man, I don't think that somehow Teddy this and that, or anything that kind of takes away the credibility as far as what he's trying to pursue. Mm-hmm. And it's like, me, I jump out and say, yo man, like, yo, don't talk about my dog like that, you feel
That's
me?
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
That's
and right. Really, because, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know, some people think that they get, When they slap you and you punch, that's just wrong because of what they did to you. But at the same time, still attacking. And I mean, that's very understandable to say, because like nowadays, don't nobody have no respect for shit no more. Nobody don't have no morals. Don't nobody have an identity or value or any type of characteristic to really carry on themselves, because we can see who you are throughout the way you act through social media. And it's so funny how cameras got niggas looking goofy nowadays.
Get you caught up.
Like, for real. So, and you can always see how, like, the people who really carry themselves in a moral perspective. And I really do commend T.I. for saying that, because at the end of the day, I don't think nobody else would have done it. I mean, of course, you would have had other people who came afterwards, but if T.I. wouldn't have did this shit, everybody would have thought that shit was cool. Mm-hmm. And then I was like, oh, like, yo, like, T.I. ass, and it's not very difficult at Black to say that wild shit. Oh, but don't nobody want T.I. Tiny or whatever. Come on, son, bro. Like, yo, that's his wife. That's his wife, son. Like, and then it's like, yo, if disrespectful is getting that bad, bro, like, what we got right now for us being leaders, and us supposed to be leaders, bro, in the future, like, yo, we already doomed, because if we ain't got no respect for nothing, who the hell are we really going to respect for?
Right.
We ain't got none of that shit, bro.
We got, like, we really gotta get it. We really gotta get it together. You know what I'm saying? Just as a collective, as a community, but as a society in general, we gotta hold ourselves accountable. We gotta hold other people accountable. But star note, importantly, we gotta hold ourselves accountable, because at the end of the day, bro, like, and I truly do live by this, bro. Like, no one can be in your head. You know what I'm saying? As much as we would love to, you know, as much as we thrive off control, yeah, as a society, one thing, bro, like, I'm telling you, no one can get inside your own head and know what you're thinking all the time, bro. And we have to be accountable for ourselves and what we're putting in our body and what we're dishing out into the world, bro, because that shit will bite you on your ass, you know what I'm saying? And the people who hold you accountable will not take the blame for what's going on with you, you know, mm-hmm. or what happens as a result of the action you did. Understand that, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You are messing up your own life.
Of course.
You feel me? So, with that being said, like, we have to, as a society, hold ourselves accountable and watch the shit that we're putting into this world, bro. Mm-hmm. And that's my thought on that.
Hey, man, and I just appreciate it, because, like, you know, I also take the time out to read, you know, other people's pages. Like, you got The Shade Room, we got Say Cheese, you got a few other people, a few other pages and stuff like that. And, you know, they always ask people, like, what are your thoughts on the situation? And I personally feel like it shouldn't even have to be, you have to think from both sides. Some people be like, oh, well, you know, he's young and this and that and the third. I mean, the nigga's over 18, so it's like, come on, man. Like, I know it gotta be somebody, like, everybody who I know who moves in that type of lifestyle has an OG or has somebody who's like has some type of weight that exceeds the other person, because, right, you know, they was able to leave. Yeah, because, you know, the reputation of these people, they can sit there and have a conversation with the person and be like, hey, look, man, I don't think that was right. I don't think that was cool for what you said. And pretty much, like, you see how Nipsey Hussle gave it up to him 2 years ago, saying, like, yo, check out Kodak Black's music. And I'm just not throwing it out there. It's like, oh, okay, yeah, he just did a little shout-out. But sometimes, you look at how the base of what this man was, he showed everybody love. So, you know what I'm saying? But for this nigga to come out and say this, in the time period where he is dead, so he can't defend himself, it looks like it's a clout chase. Cause at the end of the day, like, the nigga didn't look at the camera when he said it.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? He was talking to his niggas, and, you know, I guess he was trying to prove a point or whatever. And for that apology that he said, you know what I'm saying, that wasn't sincere. It was just saying some shit, and then he was saying, yo, if y'all want beef or whatever, we can have beef. But it's just sad, man. We don't never learn from our lessons. Like, we got this open wound. As black people, we have an open wound that we have faced through so many years, through slavery, through Jim Crow laws, to now we have in hip-hop somewhere that we actually expose and express how the way we feel. Because everybody, come on, gentrification.
We can go deep into that, yo. Bro, talk about DC and what so they doing much up there.
It's, like, it's so much going on, man. And just like, yo, like, we really need to stop the bullshit. Because now at the end of the day, because if we killing off the people who's really trying to make a difference, what are we really going to have? But we don't really have nothing.
And you want to know something else, too? It's also like, as black folk, and as just being an African American, bro, we have to value our people, bro. We have to show that we actually value each other, you know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, it's like, if we're out here not valuing ourselves, you know what I'm saying, and our culture, bro, why do you expect anyone else to hold any type of value towards us at all? Or look at us in any other light than what they already look at us as, you know what I'm saying? We have to change that narrative, because that is a false narrative, and not all of us are like that. But I'll be damned, like, I've been in the black community, too, and I've seen, like, us, like, myself being frowned on with my own community. And, like, again, going back to the Kodak Black thing, like, come on, bro, that is a black queen, bro. Like, you don't treat her, you know what I'm saying? You don't do that, you know what I'm saying? You don't do that type of shit, you know what I'm saying? You're making it look like, all right, well, if this dude can just have, cannot care about how what she's going through, then anyone else would look at it and be like, all right, you know what I'm saying? Fuck it. Especially the people who follow you and what you're doing, they're going to look at it the same way, and they might not you know, go after her, but they're gonna take that idea and they're gonna spread it in their little community of people and to the girls that they're talking to and they're where they at, you know what I'm saying, and treat them that way. Like, it's bigger. It's way bigger than just what it looks like on the screen, you know what I'm saying? When people see, bro, like, there's a ripple effect to that. And we really have to, again, like, back to accountability, we really got to work on ourselves as a culture, as a community, to grow and bind and stick together like this instead of being so, you know what I'm saying, like, I want to say hateful, but I just want, like, you know what I'm saying, we don't uplift each other enough, and we don't hold ourselves to a certain...
Niggas, shit.